another day, my people. Today is September the 12th. Today is how many days after my birthday? my guest has her phone on, so she's just re-recording me. So yeah, but today is the 12th of September. Now you would think that because my birthday was the 6th, it's past and it's business as usual. No, the momentum is rather growing because you see that it starts from the 5th. It is manifested on the 6th. It then grows momentum, gathers momentum, and then it kind of splashes coolly from the 23rd. And that is when my growth is actually manifested. So I am in the process of amazing growth right now. This time, as it is with every year since my birth, amazing things happen. This is the most amazing time of my whole growth, which will propel me into positive fighting mode until the 5th of September, 2019. So there you go. You know my story. You know my secret. Today, I again have my great, great, great. And let me tell you something, people. I am on a roll with my guest because my guest is one of those people who, when you hear of her, you're in awe. And then when you see her, you're like, oh my God. And the way that she is, you know, there's no time that we have a chat that she doesn't give me some pearl of wisdom. So today we're talking about friendship goals, and she is going to share her wisdom with us on this issue. I am then going to tell you a story, and then she's going to try and work it out and see where we go with the story. I haven't told her yet, so she doesn't know. So let's see what happens now. My guest again is Norma Ellis.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Hello. Now, I'm sure if you haven't heard of Norma before, because you haven't actually seen her in action on my show, I can tell you again that she's one of those people who has fought her way through life in a positive manner, and she has achieved a lot. She has, you know, battled with death and surprises, and she has made inroads with work. She has met people from all walks of life. And yet she's humble and sweet, and her smile can disarm a dragon. I'm telling you. So there you go. So today we have Norma on my show again. And our topic is friendship goals, positives, disappointments, and why women just can't get along. What is it with us women? Do you know anything special about us women? Why
we're competitive. We're emotional.
Is it just these two things?
We're nurturers. And we love very deeply.
So which part of it makes other women uncomfortable? You see, because nurturers, we love deeply. If that is the case, we could be loving each other and getting on with life in a beautiful manner. However, It's difficult to say.
For some of us, yes, it is. Obviously, it depends where we are in our growth and consciousness. And the biggest problem we have when we love, there's going to be jealousy.
Oh, so that fierce love
and
guarding,
yes,
that which you love.
Yes, and there's just going to be that jealousy. And also, if the individual hasn't worked on those kind of issues, then of course it becomes very challenging in their life and in other people's life as well, with the decisions they actually make and how they respond to emotions and certain challenges in life.
Wow. Challenges in life. Now, when we talk of challenges, I haven't told you the story yet.
No.
But in my life, as I'm growing up now, in the past, let's say 15 years, mm-hmm. you know, I suddenly realized that a lot of my growth is all things that I've done mm-hmm. Up till now. Mm-hmm. I was held by another woman. There was another woman somewhere. Mm-hmm. Now, a lot of the things I've done in my life since childhood, I've had my grandmother in the background. I've had my mother. Okay. And I have an amazing retinue of aunties.
Right.
My aunties are formidable.
Right.
Or, I mean, some of them have passed away. But I come from a woman-oriented world where the women are continually they're there. They're right. always there.
Right.
Now that I don't have my mother, my grandmother, and a majority of my powerfully positive aunties, mm-hmm. I have friends. Mm-hmm. Now, this is where, you know, friendship goals comes in, because I have friends. Now, friends can disappoint you. They can upset you. They can mm-hmm. take you to areas where you don't want to be.
Mm-hmm.
However, there are a few who can go with you the whole furlong.
Absolutely.
You know, because when you're down, for example, I mean, you know, you could have friends and everything is going well when there's fun and games and, you know, everything is happening, all the bad things that you want to do with your friend. But when you alone are in trouble,
mm-hmm.
they fall by the wayside.
Of course. Mm-hmm.
But there are a few. Mm-hmm. You know, I have a few friends who have I can't even imagine them. Like, where mm-hmm. I've reached in my life now,
mm-hmm.
I can't see them. Mm-hmm. ever leaving me or when I'm in trouble, they're there. They're there. And, mm-hmm. you know, and I hope that I'm there for them. However, this is it. What is the meaning of friendship goals? You know, we talk about a lot of things, couple goals, this goals, marriage goals, but friendship goals, where do we go with friendship goals? What does it mean?
I think with people, and this is all of us, we actually place a lot of expectation on others. And the biggest lesson that you will learn in your life as you go through your different challenges and as you grow,
mm-hmm.
never place expectation on others, because you will be disappointed. Because in life, we're constantly growing.
Mm-hmm.
And our perception and our consciousness and all those ha-ha moments comes at different time.
Mm-hmm.
And if we have not got the skills or have the skills to deal with certain things, then of course, you know, we're going to do the flight fright situation.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, our friends will be disappointed because we were not there to support them because they did not have those skills. Another thing with expectation is, people don't come in your life to stay forever.
You mean no one does?
No.
Really?
Death is the final thing for every one of us. So even if you have someone that goes all the way,
death is going to be.
And we have to learn that in life, we're always going to be walking this journey alone. And if we put those expectations on ourselves rather than our friendship, whether it's friends with another woman, whether it's friends in a relationship with another man, whether it's friends in a relationship with your flesh and blood, this is where we're going to fall down off those high mountain tops.
You know, just something you said just now, friends with family, like mm-hmm. children. Can your children be your friends?
They can, but they can also be disappointing because they have their own journey.
Okay.
And then we, because we think we've given birth to them, we put
they
these,
have to stay with us all yeah, the time.
Yeah, we put these expectations on them, and they can't meet those expectations because they have lessons to learn which cannot come from you.
Okay.
And it's like friends. We're all teachers in each other's life. We're mm-hmm. a reflection of each other.
Mm-hmm.
And there are going to be days when the teacher who's normally teaching you need to go off sick or go on holiday, and you have this supply teacher that comes along
mm-hmm.
and teach you that one and one make two.
Mm-hmm.
And then your teacher that was always there with you, you could never understand. How come she's getting one and one to make two? You don't understand it. But then this stranger comes along, supply teacher, and all of a sudden it goes on. Mm-hmm. And then you realize how one and one makes two. So we are there in each other's life for limited moments.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the final sort of a separation
mm-hmm.
in the physical. Mm-hmm. Now let's get this right.
In the physical. In the
physical comes with death. Physical death.
Oh my God, I don't like the death bit. Now, they say friendship goes beyond just sharing time together and is mm-hmm. long lasting. So, you know, you may have a lot of friends, but there's somebody who you value above other friends in Absolutely, your life. Somebody yeah. who you have fun with.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody you trust and someone who you can confide in.
And again, trust.
Trust.
Is another thing that we always do. Again, it's like expectation. Expectation mm-hmm. and trust
mm-hmm.
belongs to us.
Mm-hmm.
Not to give it to someone else because they are constantly growing. And you're constantly growing
Indeed.
Too.
We are all growing.
And how we are yesterday is not how we're going to be tomorrow.
Mm.
Because sometimes when you put those chains on people
mm-hmm.
and they see a mountain that they want to go and Candy is not ready to climb that mountain, how do they shake that chain free to get away from you so that they can move on to climb those mountains that they see they want to climb, but you're not ready for it and it's not your path, it's not where you want to go. So these are the issues that arise in relationships, whether they're relationships with friends that you hold dearly, that you've given all of your secrets to,
mm-hmm.
and you've shared so many good times, and whether it's mom, dad, your aunts, you know, your child. And this is where we go wrong in mm-hmm. life. Mm-hmm. And then when it goes wrong, we have these emotional outbursts because we're not able to understand because we gave all to this person.
So emotional outbursts. So what if, yes, you've had a friend, you've mm-hmm. shared your secrets with and everything, mm-hmm. but you've both moved on. You know, mm-hmm. they've moved on mm-hmm. because they, you know. Because I feel that you could have friends, you could share all sorts of things. They can move on,
mm-hmm.
but in such a way that it doesn't leave you in a lurch. So if this is friendship, I'm not talking about
mm-hmm.
like couple goals or anything. Yes. This is just plain friendship.
Yes.
So if they do and they're with you for their own selfish reasons and then move on,
mm-hmm.
are you then obligated to maintain the friendship whenever they feel they want to come back and say hello?
That's just up to you, because everything has a value. And if you valued that person's friendship in the beginning, whether they have created a issue so that they can break free, because you know sometimes, like, it's when you're you want to do something and you know the other person doesn't want to do it. But and then sometimes you don't even want that person to come with you at the time.
Mm.
You create something. You create a storm or something to happen, and you may fall out for that moment.
Mm.
And then they go off and do what they want to do, and then they come back again.
Mm.
So it doesn't really make any difference.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we are really just in each other's life for sometimes a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes for a lifetime,
mm-hmm.
but whatever that time is, you know, we need to value what we've learned from that person. And so, we need to value what that relationship meant to us. And if it had great value to you,
mm.
then of course, if they go and they come, you're quite happy. I mean, on Sunday, I met a young man,
mm-hmm.
and one of the things that he said to me, Norma, it's just amazing. No matter how long I have not seen you for years and years, it's just as if we've just picked up again.
Yeah.
It just flows. That energy is there,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that's how some friendship can be. And then there's some friendship that you might have fallen out with them and they've gone their own separate way. But because you haven't let it go and you're still truly hurt from however that circumstances that
mm-hmm.
cause the malfunction
mm-hmm.
of that relationship,
And sometimes because you weren't able to discuss it with that person and make closure. You hear of people always saying, you know, they might have a plane crash and their family might have crashed somewhere. They want to go to the site where the person crashed.
For closure.
For closure. Or even when someone died now, you see flowers get put up. Mm-hmm. It's a matter of going to that spot to make closure. Mm. So in those relationships, if the closure was not made, then of course it's always going to be a situation when you meet that person again, and it will just flag up what it is that you need to say to make those closure. And sometimes that person can't deal with it and they don't give you the opportunity to come in to actually have a discussion and to put closure to that situation.
Okay, now the story. I'll tell you the story.
Okay.
The story is, let's call one person Janice and the other one Rachel. So okay. Janice and Rachel are friends. They're kind of friends. They're kind of, you know. And then, of course, Rachel has a lot of other cousins, friends, and everything. Mm-hmm. She introduces them to Janice. Mm-hmm. Janice then has a strange falling out with one of Rachel's cousins. Mm-hmm. And so, and when she attacked her verbally by text and everything else, this is Janice, she attacked one of Rachel's cousins. So when she did that, and then they didn't hear from her again. Mm-hmm. You know, the both of them. No, I mean, she did what she did. She screamed, shouted, sent abusive messages, you know, like a troll, and then vanished. Mm-hmm. So that's fine. You know, they didn't hear from her again. But it turns out that one of Rachel's friends who she chats with had found out this issue. She then contacts Janice, and this is getting confusing, but it's actually, you know, that's how the world is. So everyone keep up. She then this is Rachel's friend, who is a common friend to all of them, you know, so she knows Janice, she knows Rachel. So she contacts Janice and tells her that, oi, Rachel is so upset with you because I hear that you went and abused her cousin. And so, because Rachel didn't know why Janice just vanished out of thin air. Do you understand? But she didn't pursue it. She didn't ring her. She didn't find out because she'd done a bad thing and they were all kind of like shocked and, you know. But this other friend, Mary, goes and tells Janice that, oh, I've heard that you've upset Rachel and her relatives, whatever, whatever. And everyone's gossiping about you in Rachel's house. So then Janice is feeling bad. She doesn't contact her, nothing. And 2 years pass. They then meet somewhere. And, you know, I mean, the families know each other. It's a long friendship. So she says, oh, it's my mother's birthday. Do you want to come to my mother's birthday? This is Janice saying this to Rachel. Rachel said, yeah, why not? I'll come. Now, it seemed like the friendship is patching up. I mean, it's a bit weak, but it's trying to patch up. So then Janice tells Rachel that actually Mary told me that you and everyone else in your family is upset with me because I had said something rude to the other friend, and so, you know, blah, 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 and all of that. Now, Rachel was astounded that how could Mary know? Because she hadn't chatted with Mary about it. But it turns out Mary's been saying a lot of snidey things about, you know, to break up the two of them, their friendship and all of that. She tells her, she tells each the other.
Different things.
Yeah, different things. And she's, you know, she's like, now they all see her as, you know, the weak one. However, in her weakness, with her mouth, she's managing to disrupt a lot of things and gossip and say negative things about each to the other all the time. So, of course, Janice tells Rachel all of this. Rachel hasn't said the things that Mary has said to her about the other woman. She hasn't. But it's quite annoying, though, if you are in the thick of it and see. Now, what do you think then should happen? Because Mary's there. She doesn't know that anyone knows about what she's done. Janice is there, and she wants to correct all the things that she's done, and Rachel is in the middle.
That is a story and a half. And I can't, and I don't even know if I can decipher it because I am trying to catch up with Janice, with Mary and Rachel.
But you see, funnily enough, this is how friendship goes, because somebody, my cousin Wendy said to me the other day that, do you know though that your best friend has a best friend and it's not you? And I was like,
well, that happens all the time.
Yes.
I mean, I've been in those kind of dynamics. I've been in those kind of dynamic relationship where you have a best friend, but she wants you to be her best friend.
Alone. Exclusive. Yeah.
And the jealousy is there because she obviously wants, she loves you very much, but she also wants to be like you.
Oh.
She wants to emanate you. But she doesn't want to emanate you in front of you. So she has other friends and other events.
And she's projecting herself like you to them.
Yes.
Ah.
So she will be over there. And I can't be friends with them. Because if I'm being friends with them,
they will see you.
She will. Exactly. You understand me?
Yeah.
So obviously it creates a problem. And then when she comes into my camp and she sees that I've got loads of friends and I don't really need you. I'm not pine as I love you to pieces.
You're my best friend, but I have other lives.
But,
yes.
But I can go without you because I have other interests, other people that makes me grow.
Yes.
Other people that make me grow. You're not the only one that makes me grow.
No.
So when she comes into my space and if there's other of my friends, you know, she's going to give the bad eyes to and, you know, look at and pretend like, you know, there's something wrong and, and won't you understand me? Sort of interact with my friends, you know? And then when my friends have gone, you know, she want to say something snidey. Oh, you think you're special. You think you're this, da-da-da-da. So the banter goes on. But I don't take all of those things serious because she's not hurting me, because the only person that you're going to be hurting is yourself.
So can you have, because you see my kind, the way that I operate really, it's not, I mean, operate is too hard, a harsh word, but I have a lot of friends. I went to a boarding school. All of my friends, I went to a school, a primary school. You know, I have friends all over the place. This is from my primary school to my secondary school, my secondary school friends. And I was actually in boarding. So, and it was more of parents who knew each other, who grew up together.
Of course.
And then their children. And then, of course, the cousins and, you know, a whole splash of people. Yes. So we've been in a same social set. Yeah, so for a long time.
Yes.
However, I float through it all because I have other friends. But I know who my friends are. So even though I'm a kind of like, I don't know how to describe myself as I'm just, you know, all over the place, flitty, bejig, or whatever the word is, with other people. Should something happen, I leave all those flitty, bejig people and I'm back into my social setting and to my friends and the people that I know, because I know that they understand me, they understand my language, they understand my craziness, they understand my nonsense.
The people that you rely on.
Yes. You see, I rely on them. And I and if I heard that they were in trouble, I would be there for them as well. You see, so even though it's seemingly symbiotic, it's very individual. I don't know how to explain. Now, there are people who are not like that. And they have friendships where they are stuck to each other for a long time. And then when they break up, it's spectacular.
Of course.
And this is the thing. You see, women are always in these situations and there's gossip at the back and all of that. I'm wondering, you know, all of this, this whole discussion came about because something happened with some friends of mine and everyone's saying everybody's bit and it was just crazy. And of course I was involved and, you know, some part of it. And then someone said, why don't you make a radio show about it? Now, it is complicated and I don't know how to explain it. It's all over the place, but I'm sure there are women out there, and this is purely for women and men too if they are interested in women's issues.
And men go through the same thing as well.
Oh, they gossip and they...
Oh, absolutely. They're the biggest gossips.
I think we have to play some music on this.
This is not a woman's thing.
Oh my God, yo. So men also gossip. Men, there you are.
Absolutely.
They said, I hear they're the biggest gossips.
They are.
Going.
They are.
Really?
And they are probably very more spiteful.
Oh my God. I know like this shirt, but your body. But you know, say, my mama don't like them. I don't want this shirt, but your body. But you know, say, my papa don't like them. Listen up. See, Shalewa. Halima. I get this friend where we get from Calabar, Labake, Fade. Come to think she be my personal person. But anytime when she come around, she get this feeling where they do me like fever. And when she dance with my mezzo boo, he de be me like Senna for Panya. Me like how she play the bass line. It makes me sing ooh la la la. The way she the way she dat. It makes me sing ooh la la la. Oh yeah. When mommy come back, she a jump. Daddy come to me a cross. And when they ask me, it wasn't me. That's what me talk say. I don't like this shirt, but your body. But you know say, my mama don't like them. I don't want this shirt, but your body. But you know say, my papa don't like them. Listen up. Oh, na, 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 na. Daddy come to me a cross. And when they ask me, it wasn't me. That's what me talk say. I don't like this shirt, but your body. But you know say, my mama don't like them. I don't want this shirt, but your body. But you know say, my papa don't like them. However, don't try me, cause if you try, I go do you many things. If you don't doubt me, don't try me, cause if you try, I go do you many things. Like how she play the bass line, it makes me sing ooh la la la. The way she the way she dat, it makes me sing ooh la la la. Oh yeah. When mommy come back, she a jump. Yay, that was
wow, that was great.
That was great, wasn't it? Oh my God.
I'm going to two party this weekend. I just hope they play some Afrobeat because it just, wow, you know, I love it. I love it.
Do you?
Yeah, it does get me
we
going.
We should make some recordings for
yeah,
you and I
gets
shall
me,
send it to you.
Gets me going.
I mean, there's another one. I'm going to play another one if people, this one is nice. I like it too, but it's not as dancey as the, it's too gentle for me, but I meant to play it tonight. Chai, chai, chai.
Don't come, I don't show.
Aye. Chai, sit.
Oh, yeah.
Jay Martens.
Aye. Chai. Oh, yo, yo.
Hey.
Everybody, everybody say. Oh, yo, yo. See, my brother, this kind of life, not too jolly, they go, eh. Oh, yo, yo.
Aye.
It no matter whether they like you or not,
chai. Yeah.
Oh, yo, yo. See, so make you stand to your feet and dance here for me, eh.
Oh, yo, yo.
Chai. Everybody say, see, as God don't wear me a brand new coat. Make una come follow me, celebrate. Everybody make una de shout, oh yo yo.
Oh yo yo, yeah, see.
See, me, I don't come with my kind of flow. Jay Martins don't come elevate. People they see me, they shout, oh yo yo.
Oh yo yo, yeah, see.
Shana God when bless me, lift me, they make me, they shine like this, yo. I him be the reason why the people they see me, they shout, oh yo yo, yeah. When I good, yo.
Everybody say,
oh, yo, yo. See, my brother, this kind of life, not too jolly, they go, eh.
Oh, yo, yo.
Wow.
Okay, now this song is nice because it says, whether you talk about me, whatever you do, God has put the shine on
absolutely.
Me, so I'm blessed.
Absolutely.
So, you know, there are some people who continually love deeply, as you say, and then they're disappointed by their friends and everything. Yes. And one of the disappointments women go through is third-party conversations.
Of course.
Like this Mary, Rachel, Janice, the whole lot.
Mm-hmm.
It's third party. Because one says the other one says, oh, my God, I didn't say that. Oh, my God, did you say that?
Yeah, well, and nobody's going to hone up. Nobody takes ownership for what they say.
No way.
Because we are always going to be in a protective mode. And we don't want people to find us out that that's the way we are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's another thing that when you're in relationship with people, the honesty, you know, or being your authentic self, whether the person like it or not, is not going to be in. It takes someone who has really grown to a certain level to develop that and realize that, okay, I said that and it's hurt you and I shouldn't have said that. Can I apologize and can we move on? And sometimes, you know, as you say, they may go away and come back and they've learned other lessons from other people. Because when you think that your lessons as finished and you run away because you didn't want to deal with it. Mary didn't want to deal with it with you know, whoever.
Janet.
And she runs away. And they blueprint these things over and over again.
Yeah.
So that, and one day that realization will say, oh, I'm fed up of running, you know.
Mm.
Because the things, as I say, is you take yourself with you wherever you go.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the same person and it's the same things that you're doing over there. You'll go and do it over there. And it's constant until you come to a realization and say, stop.
Mm-hmm.
I need to take ownership of all of these confusion. Deal with myself, you know, and learn to forgive myself for being the way that I am.
You mean when you make other people uncomfortable?
Absolutely. Mm. Because in life, forgiveness isn't just about forgiving the person.
Who upset you. It's yourself.
You have to forgive yourself.
And you have to deal with yourself.
Absolutely.
You have to own it.
You have to.
Own it.
Without a doubt.
Own it.
And that's the mistake that we make. And we think, you know, okay, I've gone to church and I've prayed and jumped a couple of hallelujahs and pray and think that, you know, Jesus or God, however you want to see it, has forgiven me. But the thing is, you have to forgive yourself.
Yeah, but why do people believe that, you see, and this is the wrong thing I find it very hypocritical when people think that because they go to church, even though they do bad things to upset other people, they are forgiven by going to church, doing the Hail Mary thing or whatever it is.
Taking a big Bible.
I find it that is so wrong.
It is.
You know, you will definitely go to hell, people.
It is.
If you are bad to your friends, you will go to hell.
You know, we all find, until you can grow, you're always going to find an excuse to practice, you know, these things that are hurtful and painful.
Mm-hmm.
And when you realize that it's not just others that you're hurting, but the most person that you're hurting
is yourself.
Because we have to make reflections. Do I like the way I feel?
Mm-hmm.
Do I like the way all of this situation makes me feel? Even though in my head, I just keep talking to block it out.
Mm-hmm.
And I run over there and I have loads of friends. You know, it's like some older people who have never learned in life, you know, to take responsibility. They have lots and lots of friends.
Mm.
They don't like being alone.
Mm.
They don't like being with self.
Mm.
And constantly, if the music is not playing or if some chatter is not going on,
they're not on the phone.
Or, you know what I'm saying? Then when they sit quietly and all the stuff that they've done keeps going on the conveyor belt in their mind and they see it. And that is scary. You know, and until you can face that conveyor belt with all the stuff that you've done and said and say, you know what? I don't really like how it makes me feel. I need to, you know, sort of, as man would say, man up, or you need to woman up.
Yeah. Or you just need to own it.
Or hone it, you know, or definitely taking that ownership for the way that you have treated certain situation that is now causing you great pain. And it keeps allowing you to keep running, you know, always running and running and running away from stuff and letting other things fill your life.
So basically, if you kind of are in a situation that you're running away from and you're not facing it to deal with it, to own it, to look at it and repair it, it's still...
You're going to repeat that situation with other people.
Yeah.
It's going to be over and over again. And then you're understanding that, you know, the same thing that I did over there, I'm doing over here. And they're saying the same thing. So over there can't be wrong.
Yeah.
If I'm over here with new people and they don't know nothing about me.
Yeah.
But they're actually saying, I'm hearing the same things that's being said. Then obviously, at some point in your life, you're going to have to stop. There has to be that full stop. And sometimes things that makes us come to that awareness, sometimes there are things that it could be grief.
Yeah.
It could be illness.
Yeah.
And something that says, you know, you need to have some healing.
You need to take stock.
Yes. And it's that spiritual healing. And when the spiritual healing comes, then the physical healing can come. So when some of us are very healed physically, as I said to you, every emotion, every illness comes from an emotional place. And when you can heal yourself and your soul, that deep soul and that spirit that's inside, when you can heal that, then that physical healing can come. And for some of us, even when we get that physical healing, it may be time for us to go home. You know, we may have to die. Some of us may...
You mean when you've had your physical healing?
Sometimes.
You die.
The spiritual healing, sometimes.
So you know, can prolong...
Sometimes.
You can prolong the healing sometimes, so that you live.
Oh my God. Know, it's like sometimes you see people who are very ill. And they're praying, and they're praying for healing, praying to get better.
Yeah.
And until they find that peace and that healing inside, and they've dealt with that spiritual stuff and the healing and the peace comes, sometimes we can get through it and keep living. And sometimes, some of us, it's time to go home.
You have reached your destination.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
Absolutely.
Anyway, somebody said, Norma, excellent insight. Read the conveyor belt. That is so true. I mean, the conveyor belt, as you were speaking, I was conjuring it in my mind. And it does happen, not only with the sins of your life or anything, but just general. When you're taking stock of things, you know, you kind
of... The reflection time. Yeah. Whatever that makes you stop. And you have to sit down and you have to take ownership of your behavior, of the things that, you know, the pain that you may have caused yourself and others. But the greatest pain that you have caused by doing that is always yourself, because you damage yourself when you're doing all these things. And that is the greatest pain.
Wow. You're so full of information and insight. You know, coming back to just so that my listener who actually suggested all of this talking about the friendship goals and the disappointments and things, how do we move from that point? You know, how do you think, does that also mean that whilst you are in pain or while you think that other people are saying things about you, character assassination, etc., etc., that you heal yourself? Or how do you come to closure with this kind of thing? Do you confront who is talking about you, or do you just let it ride and then... What do you do?
I mean, I have learned through my many years of going through these kind of situations. It's not worth having a confrontation with anyone.
Good.
Because they may not be ready to take ownership of it.
Good. I don't like confrontation.
And,
that's me.
And it will just create more stuff, because you may say something and there might just be one word
and they will
that person will hold on to.
Yes.
And they will take that one word because they're not ready and they make a whole new world out of the one word. So sometimes it is better to be in silence. Know what you know, and try to put some distance. What I have learned now through the years, as I've tried to seek my own spiritual healing, is that when all of this stuff is going on and you do put that distance between that person or whatever it is, you know, you start that healing process by either before you go to bed, play the old scene out in your imagination.
The whole scene of the whole story.
Construct, the whole scene. And give it the proper ending that you would like to see. So that's one way of starting a process, you know? Another process is, sometimes maybe those people that we've gone into those issues with, they might be dead. And you haven't had time to even make it right. So even in that place where that person has passed and you haven't made it right, or if you're in distance with them, whether on Mars or Timbuktu, it doesn't make any difference. What you need to do sometimes is to be still and put that person image in front of you and talk to them. Do that work within the spirit, because the outer man doesn't want to hear it. The outer man is the one that keeps running. But in spirit, of all of us, we are connected to each other. Whether you want to say we're connected through God or a greater force, but we're all connected.
You know,
and in that space, in that space where we put that person in front of us, we can talk to that person, and we talk to the inner spirit of that person, where in that the inner spirit is going to accept it, because the inner spirit is just love. All there is love and nothing else.
The inner spirit
is just love.
It's just love
and
people.
Nothing else. So when you speak to that person on that inner spirit, just put them in front of you, imagine they're there. You know, what was your one of your pretentious name was? Mary, what was it?
Mary
or
the gossip.
Or the first gossiper, you know what?
Yeah.
I really love you.
To say
and
that.
Yes,
I really. For the person to go to Mary and say, Mary.
No, you can't. Because
but in your head.
But yes, because the physical Mary is never going to allow you to do that.
Okay.
And that's why it's best to do the work on the inner spirit between you and Mary's spirit.
Okay.
And you sit there and you put her in front of you and you have that imagination that she's there. Mary, I love you. And I'm just so sorry, you know, that what has gone on has caused you some great pain. I don't know where it's coming from, and myself. But what I want to do right now is I'm going to forgive myself for feeling the way that I feel when I heard you said those horrible things about me.
Okay.
I'm going to forgive myself, and I'm going to forgive you.
Good.
And this is how you start participating in the spiritual sense, rather than trying to confront a person in the physical sense.
Wow.
It's like, you know, you may be at work and there is something that's going on, and there's always somebody at work that you're in some kind of hot water with that makes you feel, I just don't want to go to work.
Your boss.
That manager or whatever, she's going to keep attacking me. This, that.
That woman in
whatever.
That woman in finance.
You wake up in the morning.
Yes.
Before you go to work, you sit down in a quiet space and have her in front of you. And you
face her in your spirit
form. In your spirit form. And you speak to her. And you quietly give that love to yourself for her making you feel that way, inadequate or whatever she's doing to you. And then you give her also that love and forgive her. Because what we're all seeking for in the physical sense is love. But we don't realize that it comes from the inner spirit and it's within all of us. And when we give it, we will get it back also in abundance. But we feel that we need someone to love us, to validate us.
Oh, this is so beautiful.
You understand me?
Yes.
And you don't realize that this is what it works. So when you're in those challenges, if you can just give that person the love in the spirit, they will actually receive it in the spirit, because that's all there is. And by the time you get to work on that day, you will see
a change.
A change.
people, I'm going to play a song. Now, this song is to thank all of our, you know, our ancestors, people who've gone forward before us. Also to thank our parents. We want to thank people who've been good to us. People, you know, even more, Norma, all of this that she said, this spiritual awakening thing, this trying, we all need love. And absolutely, this song is actually about love. I'm only going to play a little bit of it. It's by Jay Martins, a Nigerian hip life singer who sings things from the heart, and he's really good. So there you go. It has begun.
Everybody get it, God, you're too much.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, friends. Thank you for just being you, everyone. Thank you. Now, Norma, we have to wrap up. We've got 4 minutes. So give me your words.
Love. I'm going to leave everybody with love.
You're going to leave everyone with
and
love.
And I think we need to really think about that.
And you also want to give us the tools for love.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If people are horrible to you, Norma, tell us, you know, like when, even though you feel negativity, whether you feel disappointment, the tools for that, Norma says, is that you wake up in the morning or before you go to bed at night, if you pray, talk to the person, say, talk to the person in the spirit form. Forgive yourself and forgive that person and send love to that person.
Absolutely.
The next time you meet that person, there will be love.
There will be. And it, and it will resolve itself. Every relationship that you think it's broken can be
resolved.
And it's how we respond to it. And that is the key. It's the response that is the most important thing to anything in life, really, how we respond and to get the right outcome.
Yes.
You know, so yeah. Love.
Love is a beautiful thing.
It is.
And when you have it, it is empowering. Love empowers people. Love gives you comfort.
It does.
It gives you a shelter.
That's all that we're all seeking for. Everybody's seeking for that. But sometimes we try to get love in different places, or we want somebody else to validate us rather than we learning to validate ourselves.
Well, again, we've come to the end of the show. This has been a beautiful discussion, and we could go on and on and on about friendship because we all have it, we all experience it, and we all want love in different forms. However, it's finished. The show has ended. But we have left you with tools on how to deal with your present life, how to deal with your relationships, how to deal with the people that you come into contact with. Again, we shall be back next Wednesday and a different topic. And we're going to talk about things that relate to all of us. Thank you so much for listening. I do love you all, whether in the spirit, whether in the flesh, the physical, whatever, in different forms, though, mind you, in different forms. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you.
Bye.
The news is about to come on, and when the news comes on, we shall go. And then that will be it.